Welcome to Worldwide Wrestling. David Crockett along with Tony Schiavone. And Tony, again, an exciting hour of Worldwide Wrestling. In there right now, the Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Vance. All right, something. And what about what we saw right at the top of the program? The Raging Bull comes off and knocks Paul Jones down in the middle of the ring.
I tell you, David, he really nailed Paul Jones. He went about three quarters away across the ring off of the top turnbuckle. And there you see the man, Jimmy Valiant. The man who is after Paul Jones with that collar around his neck. And here we go, David. Jimmy Valiant in against Joe Deaton.
Watch the Boogie Woogie Man. Oh, look at him. Hey, besides Jimmy Valiant, World's Junior Heavyweight Champion Denny Brown is here. The Barbarian Paul Jones is with us. The new World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express, are here. Plus the World Six-Man Tag Team Champions, the Koloff and Crusher Khrushchev. Valiant goes down for the pin. He's got it. What a way to start a program. The Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Valiant, is your winner.
There it is, Jimmy Valiant with the win over Joel Deaton. We take a look once again. Valiant now with Deaton into the turnbuckle to our right, whips him across. And now watch this, the elbow right square on the chin of Joel Deaton. And the winner of the match, our first match here today on Worldwide Wrestling, Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Valiant. Let's go to David Crockett.
As everyone knows, Dusty Rhodes, besides being the world's television champion, got baby doll for 30 days. He's been trying to make a lady out of her. He enlisted the help of the junior heavyweight champion, former junior heavyweight champion, Nelson Royal. He took her out to his ranch, and let's see what they try to do to baby doll.
You got him ready? You didn't get him too riled up for you, did he?
No, sir.
All right, that's
you
good.
You don't want to get her throwed off, probably.
Huh? She might need throwing off, Nelson. We fixed that.
You know, you got to have attitude adjustment cases anyway on you.
Every once in a while.
Something like she is, she needs it.
You finish that stall?
Yes, I did. And since I've done everything you've told me to in that dadgum stall, do you think maybe I could learn to ride one of these things since I've had to clean up after in the past 2 days?
I'll tell you what, if you want to ride them, you're going to have to saddle him. Is that all right with you, Nelson?
That's fine. Let's see. You sure you know how to saddle him?
I know how to saddle him.
Get on around there and get to it.
We're going to see what happened to Dusty. We're going to find out whether this woman is from Texas or from Arkansas.
Don't you help her there, Robert. Well, my goodness, look at there. You know, the blanket goes on for the saddle. Isn't that something?
I'm feeling
backwards. Oh, don't help her there. Girl, you learned to be a real lady now, ain't you?
You got a bag on.
That's good. That's good. Now what? That's the wrong end, Mama.
I'm getting there. I'm getting there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. By the time I finish with it, yeah, you'd be a lady.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
This gonna get better as the day goes on.
As the day goes on, it's gonna probably take a day for her to get up on that hard.
All right, we'll find out later on if Baby Doll knows which end of the horse to ride. J.J. Dillon and Nature Boy Buddy Lindell.
Well, David, it's an honor for you to be able to talk to me today, but it's a privilege for you to be in the person of the greatest sports attraction in the world today. And I'm not only talking about the world of professional wrestling, I'm talking about professional sports in general. And I'm referring, of course, to Nature Boy Buddy Landell, the man who is destined to be the next heavyweight champion of the world. And if it were not for some shoddy officiating on the part of a few people, he'd be the champion right now.
Let's roll it right now, and you can.
You know what I'm talking about, don't you?
I know. We'll watch and see exactly what you
do. And here's the situation again, picking out a spot where Ric Flair really looks like he's in control. And I have to say that I have the utmost respect for Ric Flair. He's managed to hold on to the world's heavyweight champion, take on all the top challengers from all over the world, but it was inevitable.
All right, what are you doing right there?
Okay, at this point...
What are you handing him?
I'm not handing him anything.
You are, too.
The crowd was cheering. He couldn't hear my instructions. I came in. I said, come on, suck it up.
That's right.
You've got enough energy left, and he showed why he is a champion. What divides the champions from those that almost make it? He hit him between the eyes, rang his bell, and covered him for the three count.
You gave him a pair of brass knuckles.
I gave him a little added confidence is what I gave him. And
brass
there the
knuckles.
Party's beginning right now. I realize that my dream has finally come true. The epitome of everything, the World Heavyweight Championship, what I've waited my whole career for, and the man that I had the confidence that could get the job done, Nature Boy Buddy Landell, right here holding the 10 pounds of gold high in the air.
Dusty Rhodes now. He's coming in. He's telling everyone exactly what
you did. He's got no business being in the ring. Shoddy officiating.
No business being in
the ring. If it wasn't for you, Nikita Koloff would probably be the world champion, but that's beside the point. Right here, the referee intimidated by the president, a two-time world champion, Dusty Rhodes. Pulled the belt away, but he got it right between the eyes where it belonged. And now, Nature Boy Buddy Landell's eating his lunch.
You know, David Crockett, when I first come here, and you're one of them, everybody looked at me and went, Nature Boy, well, prove yourself. I'll prove myself I did.
That's right.
And I took on from the bottom, and I worked my way to the top, and just like the people got through seeing on TV, a picture paints a thousand words. I had the belt over my head. It don't make any difference. I should be the world's champion right now. That's right, I said it.
He's done it once, he's gonna do it again, and Rhodes, you're gonna pay for your interference.
We'll see about that. Let's go to the ring now, and the junior heavyweight champion, Denny Brown. There you see him right there. And a fine junior heavyweight champion he is. And he's in there against the Barbarian with Paul Jones, and what an animal this man is. But Tony, just think about it. What happened to Paul Jones when the raging bull came flying off that top rope and just knocked his stiff?
Knocked his lights out, David. We took a good look at Paul Jones just moments ago and the concern on his face, and I'm sure even though Denny Brown's in there, Paul Jones had to be thinking in the back of his mind, what happened to him with the raging bull?
That is right.
That really has to be on his mind. David, you know, you touched on just briefly the fantastic Rock and Roll Express, the new World Tag Team Champions. And, you know, when you become the champions, then your work really is cut out for you.
That's right, because you're on top and everybody's trying to knock you off. You the Koloffs are going to go after him again. And also, you have the Midnight Express, the Andersons. They'll be there. Also, America's Team, Dusty Rhodes and Magnum TA. Their potential. Then you've got the Road Warriors. Barbarian's out there, and he's got a man, too, that can team up with him, the superstar. Look at that. Look at him. Look at this man.
Oh, my goodness. What power by the Barbarian.
The size of the teams that are around. The Road Warriors, the Barbarian, superstar Billy Graham, the Andersons, the Rock and Roll Express. Can they do it? Look at this. Look at this man right now. Look at the Barbarian.
Now the Barbarian asks Denny Brown to get back up. Oh, he knocks him down again. One of the most powerful men in professional wrestling, the Barbarian.
All right, the Rock and Roll Express. Think about them when you're looking at the Barbarian. Look at, watch it. He just catches him. The Barbarian catches Denny Brown. Drops him across the ropes.
You got to give it to Denny Brown. He's trying to hit him in every which way, but every time the power of the Barbarian is just too much.
He backs across. Puts his big legs across the chest and neck. Catch him with a headbutt and midsection. Snapmare by the Barbarian. grabs a hand right in the neck. Referee Tommy Young warning him. Throws him out. Well, all right, now you got to watch Paul Jones. Paul Jones, he's around. He seems kind of creeping over.
Yeah, you can see him.
There he is. He's got the cane right in the neck.
Right in the throat of Denny Brown, the World Junior Heavyweight Champion. Look at Jones over there. We take a good look at Brown. And now the Barbarian David will come over and pick him up.
He's got him. Rams that back into that steel post.
We're taking a look now at a man, the Barbarian, just really wants to hurt and intimidate people. And he does a real good job of that. He is so powerful. Now Denny Brown in a world of trouble. As you can see, slowly getting up. He's in a lot of pain, and the Barbarian knocks him back again.
Watch ball, watch ball.
The chant from the fans. Still the Barbarian, David. With that pressure. Denny Brown still cannot get back into the ring. The fans, I think, are chanting Weasel.
That they are.
Trying to upset Paul Jones.
Headbutt by the Barbarian. Takes Brown down to the mat.
Brown is, well, he's more than halfway across the ring from the Barbarian.
The Barbarian's up. He's up on top. Dives across. Headbutt. Right in the chest. He's got him down in the pan. That's it.
Right on the chest to the shoulder, David. There he is.
He's a monster of a man.
He is a mountain of a man. The Barbarian with Paul Jones and that smirk on his face. Hand is held high. We're going to take a look once again at the Barbarian and the flying headbutt. Right down the chest of Denny Brown, the winner of the match is the Barbarian. We'd like to salute our station of the week, WOLO in Columbia, South Carolina, and General Manager Don Old H. Krause. Let's take time for these commercial messages about the worldwide wrestling events coming to your area.
A great card tonight. That's tonight in the Columbus Municipal Auditorium. The NWA brings such stars as Joe Lightfoot versus Bob Roop, Rocky King and Gerald Finley versus Mike Davis and Tommy Lane. For the national title, a no disqualification match, Pistol Pez Watley goes against the champion, Black Bart. Brett Sawyer and the Italian Stallion go against the Midnight Express with Jim Cornette. Dick Slater versus Kevin Sullivan. In a non-sanctioned lights-out match, a 10-foot steel cage will surround that ring. Arn Anderson versus Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer. Let's talk to Black Bart at this time.
Pistol Pez Watley, somehow, some way, you weaseled yourself into this. And I am the man that's going to weasel you out. It's a no DQ match. Anything goes. I can bring this rope. I can bring my boots with spurs on them. I can have my chaps on. I can bring my horse if I want to, and ain't a dadgum thing anybody can do about it. Get in the ring and beat Black Bart if you think you can.
Going against Mr. Unpredictable, Dick Slater, Kevin Sullivan.
I know Dick Slater's gonna get out here and yell he wants a fight. He wants to get this over with, that he is a human being, and he's going back to the old tactics of breaking arms and legs. Well, Slater, I like it the other way. I like to bury people up to their neck in sand, dunk honey all over them, and turn the red ants loose. If you don't believe me, ask the Italian Stallion, because after I got through with him, he looked like a whole herd of red ants ate his face.
A non-sanctioned lights-out match with a 10-foot steel cage around
it. You know something? Buzz Sawyer don't learn too quick. See, you learned a couple of lessons now about messing with the Midnight Express. Last week we come in there, we broke your back one more time up against that ring post, and still you think you're going to hobble on in there. You got the promoters give you a cage match. Said, that way maybe keep the Midnight Express away from you. But you forgot one thing, Buzz Sawyer. If you crawl your crippled up little body in that ring and get yourself in that cage, you're still locked up in a cage with Arn Anderson, who is one of the toughest men in the country. He's training right now. He told me that there is no way that Buzz Sawyer's gonna beat him, but all I said, Arn, just leave a little bit of Buzz, so after that, he can get his little fat brother and come back for the Express.
Federal Express, and I see two champions. There's no doubt about that, but you got to think, though, that all eyes are pointing at them now, that the Koloffs are really hot on their trail. And, you know, not to say that when they were in that match, because the Koloffs were at the top of their game. They really were. But you got to think that they really surprised the Koloffs, because the Koloffs really didn't think they could come in and win them.
That's right. They won't surprise, as you said, the Koloffs a second time. But you've got to remember, like you said, they are on top now. Watch them. Watch this team. High flying, fast, endurance. They can do it. Watch this. Watch this. Good, good. Teamwork. Keep going. Good move. Beautiful. Oh, see, they love it. They love it.
The fans stand up as Ricky Morton that time with a flying move. There they are, Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson.
Hey, Tony, the Koloffs might have the size. The Andersons might have the size. The Midnight Express, the Road Warriors, Barbarian, and Superstar Billy Graham. But this team right there has got the desire. That's what counts right now.
There's no doubt about that. To defeat the Koloffs, to defeat the Russian team, to defeat Ivan Koloff and Crusher Khrushchev like they did, you got to have a lot of heart, a lot of desire. We saw the two young men just last week on this program win those titles. However, once you win them, it gets tougher. And you know, when the Koloffs come back after them, it's going to be a fight of all fights.
Oh, Lee. He stopped him.
Not a bad move by Sal.
That's right.
Look at this.
Good, good, good. Good, good. Right, hey, guys. Watch this.
They have a counter, it seems, for everything you can throw out to them.
They move 100 miles an hour. Their minds move 100 miles an hour.
I don't think I've ever seen a tag team come in to Worldwide Wrestling and take the world by storm.
What about the fans? They have gone with them. This is the second time they've seen them? They love them.
Sensational.
They are dynamite. They back him in to make the tag. Here it comes.
Look at that double elbow, and then that time of both with a backhand.
Headlock takeover, holds him down now. South comes up. Yeah. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, this young man in the ring right now, there you see a close-up of this young man, that is Ricky Morton. We want to remember that name, remember the face, and remember this team. The other man, the young man outside that ring, he's made the tag now, is Robert Gibson. And they make up what the fans are shouting all the time. Rock and roll. Rock and roll express.
You know, David, you said it right last week when you mentioned the Rock and Roll Express, that they are the tag team of the 80s. They represent what tag team wrestling is really all about in this country. And these two young men, I keep thinking of what happened to them last week and what a hard road it's going to be for them on down the road. But I know they'll rise to the occasion.
Snapmare, good move. Yeah, I guess too, why everybody's so happy is that World's Tag Team Championship is back where it belongs.
Finally came home.
Came home, it's with the team of the 80s, and it's back home in the USA. Has that headlock. Ricky Morton, here you see him in there again. Controlling George South. Ruffy Tommy Young looking down, checking. All right, they're up. They're back into the ropes. You watch them again, and I still have to mention the Koloffs, because Koloffs and Crusher Khrushchev, they're out there, they're watching. In fact, they're here on the boat.
Only got a two count that time, but look how Ricky Morton jumps up, and he's the first man to his feet. Sign of quickness, sign of being on top of things.
Into the ropes. Pick him up. Pick him up for a slam. Position. Knee right across the chest.
Is
tag again. Takes him, puts him across into the ropes. Here he comes. Catches him. Good drop kick right in the face. Picks him up. Let's go. Makes the tag now. Whips him across into the ropes. Double drop kick. Catches him now. That's it. You said it. That's it. Rock and roll. The team of the 80s. The world's tag team champions. Are you winners? Tony, they are great.
And the fans on their feet for the Rock and Roll Express. Winners once again, and we're going to take a look once again at one of the most awesome moves in professional wrestling, the double drop kick. Right on the button, the winner, the World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express.
Ladies and gentlemen, with great pleasure, I present the former World's Tag Team Champions, Ivan Koloff, Crusher Khrushchev, and Nikita Koloff.
Rock and Roll Express, you know deep down inside the beating you took. You know who the real world champions are. And all your great American people out there chanting USA, USA. Well, you know what USA stands for. Useless thinking Americans. Nikita, I know you have a few things to say about Ric Flair.
Ric Flair! Make Nikita mad! If it's not for you, David Crockett, Flair will be champion. Nikita, be champion. Yeah, Ric Flair, I take sickle and put on your body. I still look for you, Ric Flair. You know the last, Nikita Koloff, beware.
We will not rest. Nikita will not rest until the road to Moscow is paved in gold. Now, we've been fined many times. We've been threatened with suspension. But, you know, we don't care about this because there is nothing that is going to stop us from regaining world tag team belts. Even prejudiced referees such as yourselves, David Crockett. Now, the Kremlin is very unhappy. That makes us very unhappy, embarrassed. And they're giving us a short period of time to get world tag team belts back again. They have sent over Russian flag to inspire us some more. And we are inspired. And Rock and Roll Express or anybody else that steps in our way on this mission that we have of regaining our world tag team belts and Nikita gaining world championship away from this Ric Flair will get hurt. I'm telling you, Rock and Roll Express, you'd better look out.
With me, the Raging Bull. And Bull, on behalf of all those fans out there, I want to shake your hand.
You know, something like the Bull always said, everything comes around. You know, the message came through the airways. You know, they said they heard the Flying Burrito has hit the East Coast. You know, the East Coast, all over the worldwide. They say the Flying Burrito can fly, Daddy. And Paul Jones, a weasel, just found out how awesome this man could be. His body is a total weapon. And I just noticed he was out calling Taco Bell trying to find somebody for the recipe. Listen to me, baby. When you mess with a bull,
don't
you get
the crowd yourself.
Let me tell you something.
You're punching me.
You mess with
you
me, son, you're going to be sorry.
In the ring, and while it's going on in the ring, you're talking about Pearl Harbor. You see in the ring Nature Boy Buddy Landell, James J. Dillon. We're going to have to check with David, and hopefully the Bull is okay. My goodness. In the ring there. You're taking a look at Nature Boy Buddy Landell going up against Mark Fleming. Our next match. Well, our thoughts have to be with the Raging Bull right now, but let's turn our attention to the ring. Raging Bull, a victim of absolute. Well, David is back with us here at our ringside location. And David, if we take a look at Nature Boy Buddy Landell against Mark Fleming, that was a despicable act.
They busted him pretty good. They really did.
You know, David, and just to touch on it very briefly, when I saw what had happened to Paul Jones at the beginning of the program, you know Paul Jones, if something like that happens to him, he's always going to try to do something to the person.
Oh, my.
Paul Jones. He is a weasel. You know that?
Oh, David.
Yeah, the nickname, it fits. What a little wimp.
Well, let's try now. Focus our attention on the ring and Nature Boy Buddy Landell against Mark Fleming. And David, still coming up, we're going to take another look at Baby Doll. And you said we're going to see which end of the horse Baby Doll will ride. That's coming up, so you want to stay tuned.
Hey, you know,
look at Landell.
You look at Buddy Landell. You heard him talk about the world heavyweight champion Ric Flair and how Landell said he should be the world heavyweight champion. Also, he's after that world's television championship held by the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Look at Landell.
David, we saw earlier in the program.
The thing is, also, he's got his problems with Ron Bass.
That's right. So we saw earlier in the program, it was fairly obvious what James J. Dillon had slipped him something in his hand. You mentioned it.
That's right.
Dillon denied it, but it was obvious we saw it on the screen. That's the way he wants to be the world heavyweight champion. Then that's his own business.
Dillon said a picture's worth 1,000 words. Hey, they saw what he did.
That's right.
Hey, and we saw what Paul Jones and his two henchmen, superstar Billy Graham and the Barbarian, did.
It was absolute. They planned that from the word go. You could see that Paul Jones deliberately
positioned himself where he cannot, I'm talking about the bull cannot see them come.
That's
in.
Right. And it was, I mentioned the word Pearl Harbor.
Another man just like Jones, J.J. Dillon. They're both cut from the same mold. You know, they'll do anything to get at anybody and win any match. J.J. Dillon throws something to Buddy Landell. Paul Jones uses his cane or positions the other, like the bull positions him to where he can't see the two, I can't even say it now. The two wrestlers,
if you will.
Yeah.
You know, on the better
Superstar
side of things,
Billy Graham and the Barbarian.
That's right.
Attack the Raging Bull, but that flying burrito, you got to watch out.
Did you see that dropkick by Nature Boy Buddy Landell? It was a standing dropkick, and it really set Fleming down.
This guy, he's something.
He really is.
Too bad he's misguided.
Good look at the Nature Boy and the pressure applied to Mark Fleming.
Nature Boy Buddy Landell.
Okay, let's qualify that. Nature Boy Buddy Landell. Regardless of what you think of him, you got to realize he is one heck of an athlete.
Yes, he is.
He really is, and he has the pressure applied. And since being under the guidance of James J. Dillon, his career is really taking an upturn. And there's the man responsible right there.
Look at J.J. Look at him. There he is. Watch him.
And there's also the man responsible for that man and the rule-breaking tactics he's used. Oh, that was right across the bridge of the nose.
And that was a forearm. That was a legal blow.
That was a legal blow. And now the Nature Boy Buddy Landell tries to intimidate Tommy Young, the referee.
Right across the chest. Takes Fleming down. Buddy Landell, you don't like his mouth, you don't like his manager, but his ability to wrestle is something else. There you see J.J. Oh, he's looking right. Oh, me? I didn't do anything. Oh, not me. I'm an angel. With a twisted halo.
Get that camera off, man.
Landell.
Oh, he likes it. He likes it. He likes the camera. He likes
to be the center of attention.
Yes. And you know something? He loves it when people hate him. And there are a few people that hate him. Ric Flair, Ron Bass, Dusty Rhodes. It just goes on and on. Oh. Hip toss by Landell. Goes down.
Still to come, the U.S. heavyweight champion, Magnum T.A. He'll be on the program. We'll talk again to the Rock and Roll Express. And also, going to take a look at pressure crew chef Nikita Kolov. And like we said, another look to see how Baby Doll is doing up on the ranch with Dusty Rhodes and, of course, the former junior heavyweight champion
what
Nelson
Lloyd. What a way to make a lady. I'm going to have to remember that.
Hey, all you guys pay attention to what Dusty Rhodes does with Baby Doll. All right, still has him in that headlock. Pounds away at the midsection. Fleming trying to fight back. He's got hot. Lindau catches him in midsection.
Got to get the left to slam.
Catch super move. Here it comes. Drops a knee right across the head. Now he takes his time. Takes him back down. Right, you know, Lindau. You know, he's not trying to pin. He's just trying to show Fleming and everyone else that's watching that he can make a man suffer. Maybe he's trying to show Dusty Rhodes, Ron Bass, Magnum TA, and Ric Flair that, hey, guys, you better watch out because I can do it. Still has it in tight. Fleming trying to come up for it, trying to get out of it. Just about got it. Just about out. Comes out of it. Comes. Here he comes. Good form. Pulls it on. Across. Oh. Lindau caught him with a form right in the chest.
Tremendous blow from Landell.
Quickly picks him up with a slam. Backs in the rope. Comes off. Spins. Drops the elbow across the chest.
Right on the chest, David. That was on the button. And now, David, we're going to see him set him up. There's the figure four. And he's got it locked. Tommy Young checking.
Got it.
That's
in.
It.
All right.
Match is over, says Tommy Young. And Mark Fleming in a lot of pain. Dillon coming in. And finally, Landau gets up. There's your winner. Nature Boy Buddy Landau over Mike Fleming. Fleming still down, still a lot of pain, that left knee of his. Take a look, David, once again at the instant replay of the closing moments of the win for Nature Boy Buddy Landau.
He gets him up. Look at that slam. There you see JJ motioning.
That's right.
He said, do it. Here he goes up. Watch him spin around. Gets that weight moving. Right down. Into the chest. Your winner, the Nature Boy, Buddy Lindell. All right, now let's go and see if Baby Doll knows which end of the horse to ride. Dusty Rhodes, Nelson Royal, and Baby Doll.
Pretty good for a city girl, huh?
Well, Dusty, I'll tell you what. I don't want to see my horse hurt. Too bad you had to help her a little bit.
That's right, I did have help her. Now, darling, it's time now to show us what you got.
And this is Floyd.
This is Floyd. Floyd, let me give you a secret, son. I'll be darned. Can you believe that?
I don't believe it. I don't believe that.
That's like loading 20 sacks of feed, Jack.
Pure reason.
Look at that. I'll be darned. Get him, cowgirl. Oh, Floyd's doing good, ain't he?
What
do you think? It takes a good horse to make somebody.
Boy, I'm telling you. I'm gonna make a lady out of her yet. That's good, honey. Tell her to be proud of you. I'll be darned. Get it, cowgirl. She might work out all right anyway.
Come on, let's go, Floyd!
Hey, where you going with that horse? Hey!
Come back here.
Bring that horse back here! Hey, Floyd! Damn you! Floyd! Holy cow, Floyd!
That's what
you're doing. Bring that heart back here. Hey, Floyd! Baby Doll, I'm gonna tell you how to. Baby Doll!
Oh, man.
How far can she go?
Man, she can go. Let me tell you, it's 40 miles that way.
Holy cow. Yeah. Jesus. Floyd, run off. Baby Doll, run off. Holy cow, Jesus.
Well, Tony, Baby Doll done run off with Floyd.
I don't know what to think. She took off.
Look at Kendall Nagasaki. He realizes he's got to take it. The United States Heavyweight Champion, Magnum TA, and that's exactly what he does.
You're right, David. There's Magnum T.A. Kendo Nagasaki. Took him from the opening bell and really has just come from behind and gotten a hold of the U.S. Heavyweight Champion. Still stomping away.
He realizes he cannot let Magnum get up. Wait a minute. Whips him across into the ropes.
Boy, Magnum in a lot of trouble here, David.
Kendo Nagasaki, he's the man. He knows what he's doing. They try to catch him. Magnum's ready. Head in the belly. Takes him over the bed. Hooks the leg. He got it. Blessed him. Oh, I love it.
Now they say if you play with fire, you get burnt. And Kendo Nagasaki really lit a match underneath Magnum T.A. The drop kick.
Oh, he got it. Did he? Oh, he got it good.
And then the belly to belly. Here it comes. The winner, the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, Magnum T.A.
Let's take time out for these commercial messages about the worldwide wrestling events coming up in your area.
Great card tonight. That's tonight in the Columbus Municipal Auditorium. The National Wrestling Alliance brings Joe Lightfoot versus Bob Roop, Rocky King and Gerald Finley versus Mike Davis and Tommy Lane. In a no disqualification match, Black Bart puts up his national heavyweight title against Pistol Pez Watley, Brett Sawyer in the Italian Stallion against the Midnight Express with Jim Cornette, Dick Slater versus Kevin Sullivan. In a non-sanctioned lights out match with a 10-foot steel cage surrounding the ring, Arn Anderson versus Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer. Let's talk to Pistol Pez Watley at this time.
Black Bart, no disqualification. You talking about everything that you can bring into the ring, but you have forgot about what I can bring into the ring, including what's standing around that ring. Them chairs and them tables look good upside that big old head of yours, and that's what I'm going to put up there. No disqualification for that title. I believe that give me ample opportunity to take it from you.
Dick Slater.
Kevin Sullivan, you have jumped me everywhere I have gone. I've had to worry about you coming down from somewhere trying to do something to me. Now, you're going to have to face me eye for eye and tooth for tooth. That means whatever you're going to do to me, Kevin Sullivan, I'm going to give you the opportunity. And I'm going to tell you something right now. You're in for a heck of a fight if you think you're going to put me out of professional wrestling. And the thing I want to see is Buzz Sawyer take apart Iron Anderson in a cage.
And then the non-sanctioned match lights out with a 10-foot steel cage around the ring.
You know, it's the most dangerous match in professional wrestling today. But, Cornette, get your facts straight, Harvard graduate or whatever. The steel cage ain't over there, and it ain't up because of you. Yeah, you hurt my back. You're using me for a stepping stone. That's okay. It's up because of my brother. It's up because last time I was in Columbus, I had a poor showing because of you. I couldn't even move. My back was Welsh. Well, the steel cage, get ready. Columbus, Georgia, get ready for excitement. Get ready for the roof to pop off. Because when I take your face, Arn Anderson, and I drive it in that cage, I'm going to remember the football kick to the face. I'm going to remember you trying to take my eye out. And it's going to be a lot of blood and a lot of guts. And it ain't going to be pretty. It's going to be real gruesome. Anderson, you better train hard. Nobody better not be coming in that cage because I got Mr. Simon, Mad Dog Wayne, my little brother, be that.
With me, the world tag team champions, the Rock and Roll Express.
That's right. You know, we're out here today where we won these NWA world tag team titles, brother. And it was a long, hard fight. But I know it's going to be a bigger fight trying to hold on to these titles here. The Russians are hard on our trail, brother. They want to do anything they can to put these belts right here back around their waist. Robert and I, we've been training very hard, brother. We're looking forward to meeting these guys right here one more time to show them who's the best.
Like he said, you know, we're going to be fighting champions, and all they got to do is come after them and get them. If they can beat us, we'll be the first one to shake their hand. I don't think they can get the job done, Dave.
All right, you know, we have the Russians. The Russians are going to be out here. They're going to be wrestling. I'd like to have you guys stay and talk about the Russians and what do you think they're going to try to do to you when because you know they're going to ask for a rematch. I think they already
yes.
have.
Sure have. Well, be glad too. Like we be out here, we stay. It'd be a pleasure for us to stay out here to watch the Russians wrestle because it'll be a feather in our cap to see what they can do and how they're going
to
do it.
All right, let's go to the ring right now because the Rock and Roll Express is here to stay. Guys, let's talk about the Russians.
All right, they're big. They're awesome. They're one of the biggest tag teams, I think, in the country today. And the strongest, I have to say.
The thing is, you don't know which of the two you're going to wrestle because there are three of them. You don't know until the last which of the two you're going to wrestle.
That's right. You know, that's a feather advantage that they have because they come in the ring with three of them. Three of them steps in the ring, but you don't know which two is going to wrestle. But like Robert and I have done, we have trained for all three men. All three men, when they step in that ring, we know when we step in there, we're coming for one thing. They're coming to hurt us, and we're coming to win. Yeah.
You know what's one good thing why everybody's so happy? It's because the World's Tag Team Championship is back in the USA.
That's right. I like what I just saw a while ago. I saw that American flag in there. That's what we stand for, America. And the Russians, all I can say is, guys, come out there. The best thing you can do is just try to get these belts, because it's going to be an easy job. We can't do nothing about them guys getting on us, bro. There's a whole lot we can do to get them off.
Yeah, right there. Match is fixing to start here. It's all the Russians in their corner going over the match here. Like I said, like you said earlier, it is a pleasure to be out here representing the United States of America, what we stand for, what our men have fought and died for, our country. And these guys are here, the Russians come over here, they put us down. But, you know, they're here, they drink our milk and eat our honey, brother, but then again, they put us down. You see right here, who's this Crusher Khrushchev in there, isn't it?
Awesome. Yes, watch the Crusher, watch him start to pound away. He was in the ring against you guys, and you know the power and the might of these Russians.
That's right. You know, they come out to the ring with their strength, but like Robert and I do, we use our speed, our agility to get around this, to pass them by, to see, make them make mistakes, because no matter what sport you're in, the team that loses always loses by their mistakes.
That's right. You know, like Ricky said, it only takes 3 seconds to pin a guy's shoulders down. That's what we train for, go out there for our quickness and our ability. That's what we're going to do, man.
Here he is with a big slam. Awesome. 6 feet down on that hard ring mat.
All right, there is the coach, the professor, the team leader, Ivan Koloff. He's the man that controls that team because they're still the world six-man tag team champions. They still are.
You can't sell them short because they are the six-man tag team champions. They are very tough guys. Like I said, you can't sell the rock and roll story either. We go out there to 110% all the time. We're looking for a victory every time we go to that ring.
That's right here. Look at him. He's putting that. He's playing with him. He's toying with him. Now he's putting the boots to him right here. These guys... You know, you got to say, you cannot, you have to watch. You always got to be looking over your shoulder. You always, when you're in the ring, the whole time the match is going on, brother, you got to have both of your eyes open. You got to know where they're coming from. Because like you said, there's one on the floor moving. He can come around. These guys are here to do anything to put these world tag team titles back on.
All right, they call the Rock and Roll Express the tag team of the 80s. All right, hey, guys. They're telling me out there, the cameraman, the Russians are hollering for you, man. They want you out there now. They're saying, hey, watch this. Watch what we're going to do to this team. They want you guys to think about it. This is what they're going to do to you.
Well, that's all they're doing. They're trying to sit back here and make us want to come out to that ring right there. But, brother, anytime they want to sign a match with the Rock and Roll Express, our name will be on that contract first because we are fighting champions. They can do anything. They can say anything they want to. They can holler for the Rock and Roll Express, brother. But let me tell you right now, Jack, it was a long, hard road for the Rock and Roll Express. Nobody gave us credit for nothing, but you see where we are today, brother. We are the NWA World Tag Team titles. Nobody gave us nothing. And as you Russians go, brother, you're going to find out. You're going to find out that Rock and Roll is here to stay. Look at them. They're awesome. They're big. They're mean. They're nasty. But everybody can get nasty, brother, when you step in that ring, especially when you're fighting for your own country.
Right. Look at him. Look at him now. Look at the might of this Russian. Down, choking away. Just gets up.
The strength is just totally, these guys are here, got to be the strongest guys in professional wrestling. You can look at them, look at the body, the way it's cut, look like a chisel out of a rock. But they come from business, brother. They are mean, and I mean nasty.
You guys are on top now. Everybody wants to be World Tag Team Champions. The power and the might. Look at that. Look at that clothesline. That's what they want to do, you guys.
That's it.
How do you defend against something like that?
That's the way we won those belts right here, brother. They try to do that move with the Rock and Roll Express. But watching tapes, we outsmarted them, brother. And we're going to outsmart them again. They got their hand raised right now. But let me tell you, Rock and Roll Express, brother, we've been through some many, many wars. We've been down in the trenches before. We know how it is. Look at this right here. Totally awesome, brother. It'll take a man's head right off of you.
All right, but the thing is, can you do it a second time? Can you defend against that Russian sickle? Because they might move in Nikita in that team. You don't know which two of the three you're going to wrestle.
That's right, David. Like I said, it was hard winning these belts. It's going to be even harder trying to hold on to them, especially with all the tag teams. You got Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, and Magnum TA.
You've got the Midnight Express.
Midnight Express with Jimmy Cornette, another guy that stands out on the side of the ring with threesome. The Rushes are back. The Road Warriors. Well, brother, we've been through them, and we're going to show
Andersons,
you.
The National Andersons, Tag Team right. Champions. They're out there. Uh-huh. So, hey, you guys are up there. Everybody's talking. How long can you stay up there? That's the question right now.
I guess, Dave, only time will tell, baby. I hope we can stay up here a long time. We'll be fighting champions like we said before.
The fans standing behind us, they're standing behind us, and America, the Rock and Roll Express will stand up for them, brother, because we love them with everything we have.
All right, let's find out and see what happened to Baby Doll. We don't know where she went.
Like a little fraud went off before like that?
Not. One time he did, Dust. This sucker gone for 10 days. I couldn't find him.
10 days?
10 days he's gone, man.
Well, I'm telling you what, he's carrying a load. I hope she gets back. I'm responsible at Hearth Nelson. I know you are about your Hearth.
I hate to lose a good horse.
I hate for you to lose a good horse, too. Yeah, I tell you, it's getting dark out there, ain't it?
Good. Man, it's almost dark already.
Worldwide Wrestling is a presentation of the JCP Sports Network and has been furnished to the station for broadcast at this time in exchange for commercial consideration.
Welcome to Worldwide Wrestling, your ringside with the National Wrestling Alliance, the major leagues of professional wrestling. I'm Tony Schiavone, joined by Tully Blanchard, and as you can tell,
United
he holds...
United States heavyweight champion, Tony Schiavone.
He holds the United States heavyweight title as he won the title just this past week from former champion Magnum T.A. Also on the program today, we're going to take a look at the sensational Midnight Express with their manager, Jim Cornette, the World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express. We're going to talk, hopefully, to the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and see about Baby Doll. As you know, she left him just last week here on that program.
She can ride a horse, too, can she?
Let's talk, though, to Tully Blanchard. Tully, you have that U.S. heavyweight title, one of the most prestigious titles in the entire world right now.
Well, you know, Tony, the United States heavyweight champion throughout history has always been second in line behind Ric Flair, the World's heavyweight champion. And that's where I am right now. You know, Magnum T.A. was undefeated for over a year. Ric Flair did not pin him. Nobody pinned him. A lot of people have wrestled him 60 minutes, 45 minutes, 30 minutes, and he's pinned a lot of men with that belly-to-belly. As you just saw, he looks like he's a little bit out of control. Belly-to-belly people after the match on the floor. Well, I tell you what, Magnum T.A., I've been in many tough battles with you. But we saw what prevailed. You know, my daddy always told me the cream rises to the top. And that's what it's done. The United States heavyweight champion, Tully Blanchard. You know, I was the longest reigning world's television champion. And I'm gonna be the longest reigning United States heavyweight champion that you or anybody else has ever seen. So every time you see me on television, I'm gonna have this belt. Get used to it.
Let's go to the ring. And our first event in the ring today, you see James J. Dillon presents the Rising Sun. There's their opponents, the World Junior Heavyweight Champion on your right, Denny Brown and Stoney Burke. And there is the tag team combination, the Rising Sun. You heard Tully Blanchard mention World Heavyweight Champion, it's your boy Ric Flair. He's going to be with us on our program here today. The Heavyweight Champion of the world will be here. Also, we're going to talk to Magnum T.A., former U.S. Heavyweight Champion. There's the World Junior Heavyweight Champion, Denny Brown. A good flying leg scissor that time. And a drop kick, and out of the ring goes the Rising Sun. Brown again trying to get one of the Rising Sun tag team members back into the ring. Very mysterious team, this Rising Sun. But under the guidance, I'm sure, of James J. Dillon, they're bound to be very successful in the wars of the NWA. Brown still holds onto that arm lock. We have also here today on Worldwide Wrestling a match that is truly a main event match in any arena in the world. And I'm talking about the matchup between Cowboy Ron Bass as he goes up against the wild man from Sudan, Abdullah the Butcher. That's here today. Now the Rising Sun taking the advantage on the World Junior Heavyweight Champion, Denny Brown. You see from the back of James J. Dillon momentarily. Brown now went to the turnbuckle. Big blow to the midsection. Well, you know that the country of Japan is called the land of the Rising Sun. So obviously, Dillon has gone somewhere in the Orient to pick up this tag team combination. Still stomping away. Brown gets out of it, though. And now the very powerful youngster, Hard Rock Ricky Reed, whipped to the ropes, and a forearm that time by Denny Brown. Reeves, though, gets raked across the eyes. Dillon's up on the apron of the ring. What's going to happen here? Sets him up. Oh, a big karate chop right across the midsection. A look at Dillon now. As Tommy Young applies the count, and that's it. Excellent move by the Rising Sun. We'll take a look once again at the Rising Sun as their hands are held high. One of the tag team members will set him up. Looks like right there he's going for a pin, but watch him set him up, and this big karate chop will cut him down. The winner of the match, James J. Dillon and the Rising Sun. And I'm here at ringside, and this man, as you know, is Magnum T.A., but Magnum doesn't look too well right now, and obviously, Magnum, you can't feel too well.
Well, it's real obvious by looking at me. I've been through a lot here in the last week. Not only have I lost the United States heavyweight title to Tully Blanchard, but while making a promo for Tully Blanchard with a Philadelphia camera crew, I got jumped by Ole and Arn Anderson, tried to end my wrestling career right there in a dressing room. Well, all these things are fine and well. These things I can live with. But I've had a lot of time since losing that United States heavyweight title. I have time to review that film. I've looked at it time and time again. I can see it in my mind just as plain as day. And I'm not going to say anything about that. I'm just going to stand right out here. I'm going to let everybody out there in the home go out there and watch what happened and let them come to their own conclusion, because there's a lot of underhandedness going on out there. And I think each and every one will agree with what I say. There was something going on there that should not have been, and I'm going to do something about it.
We'll come right back and take a look at that tape he's talking about. Stay with us. Here's reminder
Oklahoma Gigantic Card of Wrestling, Municipal Auditorium in Columbus, Saturday, August 10th at 8:15. On the card, National Heavyweight Title Match, Black Bart defends against Terry Taylor. You'll see a dog cutter match. Jimmy, the Boogie Woogie Man Vine against number one Paul Jones. In a grudge match, Dick Slater takes on Kevin Sullivan, and you'll see Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer and Brett Sawyer team up to take on the Midnight Express with Jim Cornette. You can't miss this one. Coming to Columbus, Municipal Auditorium, Saturday, August 10th at 8:15.
At ringside with Magnum TA. If you've just joined us, Tully Blanchard is the U.S. heavyweight champion, won the belt from Magnum TA. Magnum, you've had a chance, you say, to look at the tape and talk about it.
That's right. It's a very interesting piece of film. I've dealt a lot of punishment out to the man here. You can see I've got everything under control. The man is virtually ready to go down. Not quite yet, but he's very, very close to the end right here. He's still got a little bit of energy left, and I'm feeling pretty confident. I'm feeling the adrenaline surge. I've come taking it right away.
Okay, words from the former U.S. heavyweight champion, Magnum T.A. And now that person came right into the ring. You saw that. Looked like a security officer had come right to the ring and handed Tully something. And thus the win for Tully Blanchard. Now in the ring, we're going to take a look at Nature Boy Buddy Landell as he goes up against Joel Deaton. Also want to let you know, as you looked at that tape, you probably were very disturbed that Tully won the title the way he did. We want to let you know something, though, that the National Wrestling Alliance, the NWA, cannot reverse a decision from viewing a videotape. That cannot be done. Therefore, if you think that maybe the NWA can do something in this situation, and maybe because of what had happened to Magnum TA, give him the title back, no, that is not the case. That cannot happen. Good hip toss by Joel Deaton. Nature Boy Buddy Landell. And Deaton goes right down with an armbar. Still to come, the World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express, the World Six-Man Tag Team Champions. Good dropkick by Landell. Oh my goodness, that put Joel Deaton right out of the ring. Also, the American Dream Dusty Rhodes, and hopefully he has located Baby Doll. Landell goes to work now as he throws Deaton back into the ring and hops back into the ring. A lot of energy in that young man, Landell. The World Heavyweight Champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair here with us. The Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez. And as we said, Abdullah the Butcher against Cowboy Ron Bass, a main event anywhere in the world, right here today on Worldwide Wrestling. The smile of James J. Dillon as Landell applies the pressure to the head. Deaton trying to fight his way out. Big slam by Landell. And a big elbow. Landell going for that figure four. You see Dillon in the bottom right hand of your screen with that hand up. There's the figure four applied. Tommy Young check it. And there's the bell. That's it. It's another win for Nature Boy Buddy Landell. James J. Dillon coming in. As Dillon slowly gets order restored, we take a look once again at the big elbow drop that will go down into the figure four leg lock. Once again, it's another impressive victory for Nature Boy Buddy Landell with manager James J. Dillon. Surrounded right now with three of the biggest men in professional wrestling, the world six-man tag team champions, Ivan Koloff, along with Nikita Koloff and Kreischer Khrushchev.
We're very proud of the fact we are still world six-man tag team champions. Now, I can't believe this Ric Flair. He comes out and he says, now he's after Nikita. For 1 year, we chased after Ric Flair to try to get him to sign world championship match against Nikita. Well, the Kremlin is very proud of Nikita. I am very, very proud of the accomplishments of Nikita. And I know Crusher is. But we also know down deep, the Kremlin is only going to be completely happy when Nikita is wearing world championship belt around his waist. And this Ric Flair is out of the picture altogether. Because this is where it belongs, on Nikita's waist. and we have a film here to show why the Kremlin is so very proud and told us that time and time again. All the American people are telling us this. But you have met your match now. It is over for you, Ric Flair. You're going down. Right? Looking at you again is only a matter of time as you go down to Nagida Corner.
Stay tuned, we're coming right back. Worldwide Wrestling salutes at Station of the Week, WHKY at Hickory, North Carolina. Station and General Manager. When you talk about tag team combinations, you look no further than the NWA and Worldwide Wrestling. And one of the tag team combinations coming very soon is the Midnight Express and one of the most flamboyant managers in the history of professional wrestling, Jim Cornette. Let's go right now and take a look at Jim Cornette and the Midnight Express. That's Jim Cornette, I think. Jim Cornette is asking for David Crockett to go. There's David asking him to go to the ring.
Nobody in professional wrestling but myself has the quality, the capacity to introduce my men. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you now something the likes of which you've never seen before. The most dangerous combination of professional sports. The skill, the strength, the stamina, and the ability of two men blended together as one. The most exciting combination in the history of professional wrestling, twin sons of different mothers, lover boy Dennis and beautiful Bobby, the Midnight Express. Now.
Express, and what an introduction Jim Cornette gave, David. He wanted you to come over, and he took the microphone, and
this is going to be interesting.
Jim Cornette, the manager of the Midnight Express, and that's the combination of the Midnight Express you see in the ring. Beautiful Bobby and lover boy Dennis.
And beautiful Bobby is in the ring right now. Let's see how he does. This is my... really the first time I've seen them in action. I've heard a lot about them.
Yeah, you take a look at the Midnight Express as lover boy Dennis comes in. Backbreaker. Oh, that was an awesome backbreaker. And right on the chest of Larry Clark. The Midnight Express teaming out quite well.
They've impressed me.
Beautiful Bobby. Oh, my goodness.
What an elbow. What an elbow.
A gigantic elbow. We're going to take a look once again. You want to see that elbow again? Let's take a look once again at the elbow. Right down on him. On the shoulder. And we're back to live action again.
And they are destroying this team.
You see at ringside, Jim Cornette, you know, David, I had a chance to check on the background of Jim Cornette. Comes from a very, very wealthy family, and the way he got into professional wrestling was his family just really footed the whole bill. Never really had to work a day in his life, I understand. Don't tell him I said that.
All right.
Okay. Jim Cornette says, tell them how great we are. I think they can see for themselves. Jim Cornette, obviously a lot of money, and just a rich kid who's become a professional wrestling manager. There you see Jim Cornette.
He can sue that body for non-support right there.
Cornette. And now, as we take a look.
Matt Mayer. Lover boy Dennis. He's the one. Watch. Point him around in midair.
Here's beautiful Bobby, the Midnight Express, stomping away. Clock swept in. Big elbow. This is one of the top tag teams in the entire world today, the Midnight Express.
Watch it, Tony. I have to agree with you. Good teamwork. They know how to wrestle. And they know how to destroy a team.
Oh, and David, they are so quick.
What's the matter with you, boy?
They are so quick.
That's one of the big advantages they have. They are quick.
Not only that, you would have to think that Cornette really psychs people out at ringside.
He's constant motion himself. He knows he's always pacing up and down.
Look, Cornette down at ringside, calling Clark a punk.
You want to be a wrestler? Fight for it, darling.
Boy, is he it's awful easy to talk when your big man's on top of it. But Cornette, look how happy he is at ringside. Has that tennis racket.
Lover boy Dennis, that's the man in there right now. See what he does. Has him up. Wait a minute. Look at this. Position. Bam. Good slam. Picks him up again. Didn't try to pin. All right. Man, watch it. Watch it. Watch it.
Oh, my goodness. That was incredible. And that's it. The Midnight Express. And I mean, of all teams we have seen, that may have been the most incredible move we've ever.
I don't know about you, but they have impressed me.
We're going to take
him or not, they have impressed. Now watch this. Watch this, Tony. All right. He's positioned, drops down behind. Side body block. Takes him over. Crushed him.
Just like a prank you used to play when you were a youngster when the guy got down behind, but this time with violence. The winners of Midnight Express. Gibson outside of the ring. Ricky Morton inside. Going up against Lee Ramsey and Mark Fleming. Here is tag team competition. The Rock and Roll Express. Good arm whip. Backdrop. A high backdrop by Morton. Reversal that time. Ramsey with the backdrop. To be at ringside with these two men won the world's tag team title, and even though they have those titles right now, you got to keep in the back of your mind that the Russian team is still around, and the Russian team still wants those titles back. And something I wouldn't want to do is make Ivan Kolov, Nikita Kolov, or Pyotr Khrushchev mad. You know, when you contend with two of them, you've got to really contend with three. But as the fans chant, rock and roll, the tag team of the 80s, Rock and Roll Express. Really on a hot streak. Came to Worldwide Wrestling, the NWA, and won those titles right here on Nationwide TV. Down is Ramsey. The fans love it. The World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express, win once again. Tommy Young will give the titles to him. We'll see the double drop kick and watch Lee Ramsey get it right on the button. Bang, bang, 1-2. He goes down. The winners, the World Tag Team Champions of Rock and Roll Express. Don't go away.
Here's what my wonder of a gigantic card of wrestling. Municipal Auditorium in Columbus, Saturday, August 10th at 8:15. On the card, national heavyweight title match. Black Bart defends against Terry Taylor. You'll see a dog cutter match. Jimmy, the boogie-woogie man, vying against number one Paul Jones. In a grudge match, Dick Slater takes on Kevin Sullivan. And you'll see Mad Dog Messiah and Brett Sawyer team up to take on the Midnight Express with Jim Cornette. You can't miss this one. Coming to Columbus, Municipal Auditorium, Saturday, August 10th.
Well, last week we were all concerned because she had run away on Floyd the Horse, but Dusty Rhodes, Baby Doll's
here. I'm a little disgusted with Baby Doll. You need to get back in the truck, Mama. That's where you need to be right now.
Dusty, I'll do anything you want. I'll even go back to Hawaii.
Hawaii? Hawaii what? Let me see one thing real clear, America. I know, Magnum T.A., Tully Blanchard, I know who it was. There ain't no doubt. No doubt at all, Tully Blanchard. When she ran away with Floyd, you had that picked up somewhere along Life's Highway. And that's risky business. And then, as far as I'm concerned, Tony Schiavone, when she showed up in a uniform and gave Tully Blanchard the equalizer, I know who it was. And I got about 14, 15 days left, Baby Doll. And you're gonna spend the most horrible time of your life. I'm gonna make you, within a short period of time, go to Magnum TA and get on your knees and face him, baby, and say, darling, I'm sorry. I want to be the lady that Dusty Rhodes is going to make of me. And Tully Blanchard, you ain't no man. You ain't no champion. You have the heart of a coward. You are a coward. And Magnum, I'm sorry about this thing, Daddy, but the dream's going to make it right. You can bet on it.
Here's a reminder of a gigantic card of wrestling. Municipal Auditorium in Columbus, Saturday, August 10th at 8:15. On the card, national heavyweight title match. Black Bart defends against Terry Taylor. You'll see a dog cutter match. Jimmy, the boogie-woogie man, vying against number one Paul Jones. In a grudge match, Dick Slater takes on Kevin Sullivan. And you'll see Mad Dog Messiah and Brett Sawyer team up to take on the Midnight Express with Jim Cornette. You can't miss this one. Coming to Columbus, Municipal Auditorium, Saturday, August 10th at 8:15.
This man, other than to tell you, we are always honored to have the world heavyweight champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair, join us at ringside.
Well, Tony, you know, my concentration in this sport sometimes is on a general basis, because every night that I'm in that ring, I'm wrestling the best competition that each area around the United States of America and each promoter that the National Wrestling Alliance has can put in the ring each night. You see, I wrestle the top guys, night in and night out, the best this sport has to offer. And I pride myself on being the best because I face the best and I've beaten the best. Well, let's lay it down on a real thin line right now. It's real hard for me to sit in that dressing room and watch that film that you played earlier of Nikita Koloff clotheslining me, give me the Russian sickle, not by himself, but with Ivan Koloff holding me. You see, Nikita, it's real easy for you to stand here, your big muscles all greased up, looking so bad, telling the world that when you get me, you're gonna take this back to Moscow. Well, let me tell you something, partner. In my day and time, there have been a lot of guys, have told me they're going to take this somewhere else besides my house. But Nikita, you know, they didn't play that whole film. And they neglected to tell the world that at about the 30-minute mark, those big arms of yours and that big chest got a little tired. got a little tired. You know what I'm telling you? And you were going, that's right. You see, I'm not as big as you, but I'm better. You understand? And I'm a better man. And Nikita, you and I next time, all alone, I don't care where it is. I promise you, I promise Moscow, and I promise every wrestling fan alive, you're gonna be mine. Woo!
Let's go to the ring. World Heavyweight Champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair, and a very disturbed man, very angry at Nikita Koloff. Understandably so. There's the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, the new champion, Tully Blanchard. And a very stern test for the new U.S. Heavyweight Champion, and that big man right there, well over 300 pounds, the American Starship Eagle. Tommy Young, the referee, and it's our first look at Tully Blanchard since he has regained, or since he has taken, I should say, since he has taken the U.S. Heavyweight title from Magnum T.A. And what about what Dusty Rhodes had to say? He said it right here on TV. He said, Tully Blanchard, you have the heart of a coward. Well, we saw what looked to be a security officer come in, hand something to Tully Blanchard, and then seconds later, he was a U.S. Heavyweight Champion. Dusty Rhodes says he knows who it is. I think you, the fans out there, can make a judgment. Magnum says the same thing. But the bottom line is that Tully Blanchard is the United States Heavyweight Champion. Now Blanchard very upset at Tommy Young, the referee. He's claiming now that Tommy's not calling for a break. Blanchard really will have a tough time with this big man. As you know, Blanchard's favorite move is the slingshot suplex. And that's a big man to get up into a slingshot suplex. The chant of the fans trying to disrupt the concentration of Blanchard. Blanchard strikes the big man. He shouldn't have done that. The Eagle chasing Blanchard. Look at him run. A little bit of give to the ring. There's none to the floor. It's the full Nelson. The full Nelson on Blanchard. Trying to escape and gets to the ropes. The fans are going crazy. Obviously, Blanchard's going to find defending this U.S. Heavyweight title. In the wars of the NWA. There's a knee, though. Blanchard caught him with a quick knee to the midsection. Reversal! Blanchard! Oh, a great move! You gotta give it to the U.S. Heavyweight Champion. That time, the Eagle was ready for a backdrop, but Blanchard caught him right by the head. The chant of Eagle from the fans as Blanchard sets the big man down with a four. That time it was close to the end for the American Starship Eagle, but he rolled out of it. The pace of this match is furious. A good toss that time by the Eagle. Blanchard rolls him up. That's it. Tommy Young couldn't see it. It was clear on your screen that Blanchard had used the ropes. Meltzer stretches the rules, uses something to get the win away from his opponent. We're going to take a look once again. Now the American Starship Eagle's really on a roll at this time. Down he goes. Tommy Young cannot see this, but you can. There's how your U.S. champion wins his matches.
Reminder of a gigantic card of wrestling, Municipal Auditorium in Columbus, Saturday, August 10th at 8:15. On the card, national heavyweight title match, Black Bart defends against Terry Taylor. You'll see a dog cutter match. Jimmy, the Boogie Woogie Man Vian against number one Paul Jones in a grudge match. Dick Slater takes on Kevin Sullivan, and you'll see Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer and Brett Sawyer team up to take on the Midnight Express with Jim Cornette. You can't miss this one. Coming to Columbus, Municipal Auditorium, Saturday, August 10th at 8:15.
Last week, it was a vicious and deliberate attack from Paul Jones and his men on this man, the Raging Bull.
You know, every time somebody has to do something, they got to do it 3-on-1, 2-on-1, whatever. Everybody wants to hurt the bull somehow. And I heard somebody tell me through the grapevine that Paul Jones has got a library collecting about videos about me. Well, I'll tell you what, you can collect all the videos you want about me, Daddy, but I ain't sticking around to see them because I'm going to make some of my own.
Let's take a look at what he was talking about.
With me, the Raging Bull. And Bull, on behalf of all those fans out there, I want to shake your hand.
You know, something like the Bull always said, everything comes around. You know, the message came through the airways. You know, they said they heard the Flying Burrito has hit the East Coast. You know, the East Coast, all over the worldwide. They said the Flying Burrito can fly, Daddy. And Paul Jones, a weasel, just found out how awesome this man could be. His body is a total weapon. And I just noticed he was out calling Taco Bell trying to find somebody for the recipe. Listen to me, baby. When you mess with a bull,
don't
you get
proud yourself.
Let me tell you something.
You're punching me.
You mess with
you're
me,
sucker.
And you're going to be sorry.
Get up there, right there.
Cut it out. Come on. Quit it. Quit waiting. Come on. Come on, Jones. Cut it out. Well, as we said, it was a vicious attack. And now, let's go to the ring. Well, as we said, a main event from anywhere in the world. It's Cowboy Rod Nash, Abdullah the Butcher, on the floor. Bass going right after the big man. Into the steel post. Two giant men. Ron Bass, Abdullah the Butcher. Right here on World Head Wrestling. Still, the action takes place outside of the ring. Finally now, the Butcher gets to the ring. As you know, Cowboy Ron Bass, a changed man. For a long time, he really helped James J. Dillon make a name for himself. All the titles that he had won for Dillon. The Butcher, oh, he comes off with a blow to the throat. That was right in the throat. You see the right hand taped up as it rests on that rope. Obviously, it caught him right in the main event match anywhere in the world. Ripped to the rope. Once again, he hits it. Will that take it? Oh, no. The elbow. He moved. Bass may be setting him up for the claw. Dillon, they both got him from behind, and now both men are stomping at Cowboy. Dusty Rhodes has come in and everybody takes a powder. The American Dream clears house. And that certainly is a good sight to see Dusty Rhodes come in. But not a good sight is to see Cowboy Ron Bats on his back on the ring. Bats will win the match on disqualification. And now Dusty. Dusty's going to help the big cowboy up. And they embrace. Oh, that's a great sight. Cowboy Ron Bass knows he has a friend in Dusty Rhodes. The winner of the match by disqualification, Cowboy Ron Bass, with help from Dusty Rhodes. At ringside, we're going to take a look once again as the outstretched hand from the American Dream offering his help to Cowboy Ron Bass. As we said, the cowboy, a changed man, and he looks across at his friend, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes.
Let's take time out for these commercial messages about the worldwide wrestling events coming up in your area.
A spectacular card comes to the Columbus Municipal Auditorium Saturday, August the 10th, 8:15 p.m. We have such stars as Rocky King versus Mike Davis, the Italian Stallion versus Bob Roop. For the National Heavyweight title, Black Bart defends his championship against Terry Taylor. In a dog collar match, that's right, a dog collar match, Paul Jones versus the Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Valiant. In a lights out, anything goes match, Dick Slater versus Kevin Sullivan. Tag team action, we have the Midnight Express with Jim Cornette versus Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer and Brett Sawyer. Let's talk to Dick Slater at this time.
See, Kevin Sullivan, I'm not trying to fight Boo to Dean or the Lady of the Third Eye. Me and her may just walk out of Columbus arm in arm. But the thing I'm doing is, see, you lethally, I will say the National Wrestling Alliance lethally gives me the opportunity to wrestle you in my kind of match. And that means no rules whatsoever. Now, you talk about nasty individuals. Everybody in Columbus, Georgia knows how nasty Dick Slater could get. If it comes right down to it, Kevin Sullivan, I will bring a 2x4 in the ring and clean your clock. Don't try to put a mojo on me. Lights out match, anything goes. It's going to be a fight to the finish. And Sid Sullivan, as far as I'm concerned, I'm going to still be here.
August the 10th, the Sawyers go against the Midnight Express.
That's going to be a rough and tough. You know, that Sullivan, he's been out here running like a goofball, looking up at the stars and the moon. He picked the right guy when he picked Dickie Slater, Mr. Excitement. Always excited.
Yeah, really.
Now we're talking about a Midnight Express.
Jimmy Cornette.
You remember what happened in the cage match with Arn Anderson? It was all over and done with. I beat the man right in the middle, 1, 2, 3. They open the door, and what happens? In comes the Midnight Express. It leaves me laying like a dog. Well, I am a dog. So I get right back up and I start fighting again. So Midnight Express, Brett Wayne Sawyer, and the Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer, we're gonna be there in Columbus, Georgia, and we're gonna be there ready to fight. Like two mad dogs. You think they used to call me the Mad Pup? Well, let me tell you something. We've changed it since the Midnight Express. Now, I'm the Mad Dog, and you're gonna see two mad dogs. We'll be there.
As we take a look at the World Six-Man Tag Team Champions, Ivan Kolob, Nikita Kolob, and Kreischer Khrushchev in against Sam Houston, Stoney Burke, and Patrick Tanaka. We're joined by the World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express. This Russian team is really awesome, Ricky Morton.
You got that right, Tony. There are three big individual guys. I say they got to be the strongest in professional wrestling. Look at Nikita here, picking up Patrick Tanaka, up over his head, at least 6 feet in the air. Tell me these guys right here don't have strength behind them, brother.
And, Robert, you know that they are out after those World Tag Team titles to get those back.
That's right, Tony. We took the titles from these guys. They're a very tough team. What they want to do, they want to get the World Tag Team belts back around their waist. And what they got to do, Tony, is beat the Rock and Roll Express.
Look at that move on Tanaka. Kolob had held him up.
Well, they put him right down.
Now all men are in the ring.
Guys, man. They're individuals.
They really are. They throw all of them out now. And they're stomping away.
They got Patrick. Hey, I can't take no more of this, bro. Come on, hey.
Wait a minute now. Where are you going? The Khrushchev and Ivan Koloff. Look at Nikita. Oh, Nikita gets Ricky Morton from behind. Ricky Morton is down. He's down. Look at him. He's down on the mat. And now all three men work out Robert Gibson. Out goes Gibson. Look, Morton is still down. He has not moved from that blow to the back. Oh, my goodness. What is he doing? Nikita holding up. Ivan's going up. Oh, my goodness. It's an elbow. Morton is hurt. He is definitely hurt. They're stomping away at Ricky Morton. The Rock and Roll Express, they came to the ring. They could not stand what the Russians were doing to Patrick Tanaka as all three were stomping away. Oh, my goodness. They're going to try to hurt him even more. Robert Gibson came in, as you can see. He came in to protect his partner. Oh, the Russian team stomping away at the Rock and Roll Express. Just trying to hurt the Express. Out they go. I can't believe. There's Ric Flair. There's the world champion. There's Ric Flair. Ric Flair is at the ring. He and Nikita Koloff in the ring. Toe to toe. Tommy Young. He's been thrown away. Oh, where is Nikita Koloff going now? Dusty Rhodes has come in. Magnum T.A. is in. This has been an incredible hour of worldwide wrestling. And we're going to have to leave you very shortly. The Rock and Roll Express came in. They came in to take charge. And finally, it was the world champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair, who came in and clean house. There you see the Russian team leaving the ring. We certainly hope the Rock and Roll Express is okay. They were thrown out of the ring. And Ric Flair, Dusty Rhodes, and Magnum had come in. Now they seem to be okay as Ric Flair checks on them. We will see you next week for more of the best on Worldwide Wrestling.